Good morning, Madam Dr. Present here. I am Ashrita of Class 9C and we are going to present a skit on the millet year 2023. There are many farmers in our country who grow rice and wheat. Priya is one such an ordinary farmer in the village called Ankapalli. She grows rice in her village, but she never got enough money to live comfortably.
How are you, Priya?
Not so good, Dragon. This year too my expenses to buy fertilizers and pesticides for my rice. Crops went high and day by day this prices kept on increasing.
This is not nice thing to hear. I'm sorry.
What can we farmers do, Raven?
Why don't you try growing millets?
Millets?
Yes, millets. Don't you know that Sarkar is launching a new program to increase the consumption and production of millets year 2023?
What actually is millets year 2023?
Thousands of people like you grow rice and wheat in their fields and let them to have very little amount of profit. But millets do not require lot of pesticides, which means we need not spend on these fertilizers.
Really?
Yes, I have learned this from my campaign by Bhavya. If you are interested, you can also join me to learn more about millets.
I would love to come.
That evening, Revant and Priya went to the meeting. Good morning everyone, friends who are here. My name is Bhavya and today we are here to talk about the benefits of producing and consuming millets. So as we know, that rice and wheat have been our country's staple food for several years. And since we grow rice and wheat in such high amounts, we spend a lot of money on pesticides and fertilizers. Fertilizers are poisoning our health and even the soils. And if the crops fail due to natural disasters, we lose all our time, money and hard work.
But ma'am, if we don't use fertilizers, the crop yield is not good. So we will still be in loss.
Ma'am, you are only worrying about the electricity bill, but the government is worrying about the decreasing of groundwater level. And the rice requires at least 1900 to 5000 liters of water per kg of rice to grow.
Madam, what do you suppose us to do now? Is the Sarkar going to annex our fields to stop us from growing rice?
No, no, sir. Don't worry. Sarkar is very friendly to the farmers. We came here with a proposal.
We want you to grow millets.
Millets? We as a created long back during our childhood. But all by themselves, we will be at loss if we grow millets.
Growing millets is actually profitable as they need less water, no fertilizer, and the best part is that they can grow in barren land. They don't need extra care, they don't attract pests. To make it even more profitable, the government has raised the price of the millet so that the farmer have to not worry about the financial stability. Government also promised to give a short prices.
Sir, millets aren't purchased by many people because they are cheap. It is also considered as layman's food. Nowadays, people become rich, so they don't want to eat cheap food.
The government will fix the price. The government has taken a pledge to create awareness among people and government will make sure that farmers aren't at loss.
Already, this is an experimental in the state, Odisha, and they got good profits to the farmer and the government too.
The government of India wants to spread awareness about growing millets in other parts of the nation too.
But what about nutritious benefits?
Well, to explain that, we have a very special guest. Please welcome Ms. Janvi, nutritionist.
Good morning, one and all present here. I'm Janvi. I'm a nutritionist. Today, I'm here to explain the benefits of consuming millets. See, millets are a superfood to start off. They are rich in dietary fibers. They also support good bacteria in the digestive system. They reduce the risk of cancers. So that's why the United Nations has declared millets as a superfood this year.
Thank you.
Plus, the process of growing these millets does not affect the environment, so it is a win-win at both ends.
And also the government offering 15 to 20,000 rupees per hectare if you grow millets and as to support the farmers.
They need an end. And on the way back to her house, Priya says to Revan,
"Thank you, Revan. Had you not told me about the meeting, I would not have been known about the millets here."
"No worries, Priya. Just make sure you plant millets every year."
And after a year, both Priya and Revan harvested millets and got good profits after selling them and they lived a comfortable life. So, let's pledge to include millets in our daily meal to help the farmers and also the nation.
Now, let's take a pledge. I pledge to eat.
One
millet meal. A day. I pledge to bring back. The glory of. Millets to increase. Consume.
Consumption.
And make Indian farmers. And marketers. Atmanirbhar. I pledge to promote. Millets. To foster climate resilient. And smart agriculture. I pledge to cultivate.
Resilience.
And health. For zero hunger.
We thank Sunila ma'am and Kamarani ma'am for helping us in the making of this kit. Thank you.